Okay, we're back for some more physics problem solving. We're still working on forces, and so we're going to do another example of a force problem that has multiple dimensions, and again, another example of a problem that involves tensions. So this is a problem that we've talked about before, the idea of hanging a picture. So this is a picture of my two cats, Newton and Curie, named for Isaac Newton and Marie Curie. And in this case, the picture is hanging from two strings, which are tied to the picture and pointing at different angles from the top of the picture. And so if the picture is a mass of 0.75 kilograms and the two strings have angles of 65 degrees and 32 degrees, as shown in the picture here, then what I'd like to know is what is the tension in each of the two strings? Okay? So as with all force problems, the place where we start is drawing a free body diagram. So in this case, I will draw a free body diagram for the picture. Okay, and the picture has its weight. That is the weight of the Earth pulling down on the picture. And we know that that weight is equal in magnitude times the mass of the picture times the acceleration due to gravity, g. There is one string, so we'll call that tension of string 2 on the picture, pulling upward and to the right. And there is a second string, we'll call that the tension of string 1 on the picture, pulling upward and to the left. And the problem statement is that those two tensions are at specified angles. In this case, this is at 32 degrees, and the tension from string 1 is at 65 degrees. Now, one of the things that I've often advocated doing, and I think it's useful in helping you get your equation set up right when you impose Newton's second law, is redrawing the free body diagram a second time. I always draw this first free body diagram to make sure I get all my forces and that it matches the picture. But before I set up Newton's second law, I like to redraw the free body diagram a second time. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw another free body diagram, which is exactly equivalent to this first one. But in this case, I'm going to break all of the forces up into their individual components. Okay, so in this case, I'm going to set up a coordinate system which has plus x and plus y in the usual directions. And so now, when I draw a free body diagram for the picture, I will have several forces that point in the vertical direction and several forces that point in the horizontal direction, but no forces pointing at diagonal angles. So once again, I have the weight of the Earth pulling on the picture. And then in the horizontal direction, I have the x component of the tension from each of the two strings. So that corresponds to an x component. Let's call that T1x, and I'll just keep those two subscripts to simplify our notation here for the moment. And then I'll have T2x. And then similarly, in the y direction, I have y components from each of those two tensions. So on here, I have T1y, and here I have T2y, which I've drawn for the moment with arbitrary length because I don't know anything about their magnitudes. I drew these magnitudes with arbitrary length. So the lengths that I've drawn here are representative of the magnitude of the components in this diagram. But for the moment, I don't actually know what those values are. Now, the reason that I draw this free body diagram this way is because it immediately tells me some very important things. And in particular, if I look at the horizontal forces, I see that the magnitudes of the horizontal components of the tension have to be equal. How do I know that? Well, my picture is not accelerating. It has a speed of zero, and it's speed remains zero, so the picture is not accelerating. So just looking at this free body diagram, I immediately see that these two components of the tensions have to balance. And that's going to be quite valuable to us as we go forward and solve the problem. Okay, so with our free body diagrams done, The next thing I do is I write out Newton's second law. And Newton's second law is that the net force, the sum of all the forces, is equal to the mass times the net acceleration. And in this case, Newton's second law, in all cases, Newton's second law, applies not only to the vector statement, that the vector sum of the forces is equal to the magnitude of the overall acceleration, but the component version of Newton's second law works as well. And so in this case, I can write that the sum of all the forces in the x direction must equal the mass of the picture times the acceleration in the x direction. As we just said a moment ago, that means that the acceleration of the picture is zero, so this whole thing is equal to zero. And if I simply read off my free body diagram, I can write this as the tension of string 2 in the x direction plus the tension of string 1 in the x direction. And I will indicate that by a minus sign, that they point in opposite directions. And so I can write that. And this immediately leads to the statement that T2x is equal to T1x, as we said a moment ago. Now I know exactly what these components of the tension are. I know that T2x is the magnitude of tension 2 times the cosine of my 32 degrees. And that is equal to the x component of tension 1, which is the magnitude of tension 1 times the cosine of 65 degrees. Okay? And so if I were to solve this for the ratio of tension 1 to tension 2, that tells me that T1 over T2 is equal to the cosine of 32 degrees over the cosine of 65 degrees. And if I evaluate what the cosine of 32 divided by the cosine of 65 is, I get 2.0. So what that tells me is that the magnitude of the tension in string 1 is equal to twice the magnitude of the tension in string 2. Okay, so that's a very important bit that we will find useful as we continue on with our solution. Okay, so the next step is to do exactly the same thing. We can use Newton's second law, and this time we're going to do it in the y direction. So we're going to need the components in the y direction, so let me go ahead and work those out. T1y is equal to T1 times the sine of 65 degrees, but I know that T1 is twice T2, so I can really write this as 2T2 times the sine of 65 degrees. You see, we've now eliminated one of the tensions, so what we're going to end up with in the end is the value for T2. And T2y is equal to the magnitude of T2 times the sine of 32 degrees. Okay? So if I work out Newton's second law, that says that the sum of the forces in the y direction must equal to the mass times the acceleration in the y direction. That must be zero because our picture is not accelerating. And so again, if I look at my free body diagram, that is T1y plus T2y minus the weight, which is pointing in the opposite direction. So this is T1y plus T2y minus the weight. I have expressions for all of these things. T1y is 2t2 times the sine of theta. So 2t2 times the sine of 65 degrees plus t2y, which is t2 times the sine of 32 degrees minus the weight, which is mass times the acceleration due to gravity, is equal to zero. And so if I do a little algebra here, I can get that T2 times 2 times the sine of 65 degrees plus the sine of 32 degrees is equal to mass times little g. And so T2 is equal to mg over 2 times the sine of 65 degrees plus the sine of 32 degrees. And so if I insert the numbers, this is the mass of my picture, which is 0.75 kilograms. The acceleration due to gravity is 9.80 meters per second per second. Two times the sine of 65 degrees plus the sine of 32 degrees. And if I work that all out, I find that T2 is equal to 3.1 newtons. And as we said above, T1 is twice T2. So if I work that out, that means that T1 is equal to 6.2 newtons. And so there we have the tension in the two strings that are supporting the one picture of my two cats. Okay? So good luck working on force problems. We'll do a few more, and I'll talk to you later.